Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the fifth intermission video of this character course. And I want to say congratulations for pushing past the halfway point, because I did mention in the previous video that the halfway point is one of the biggest danger zones for a lot of artists. Most of us, we probably get frustrated and fatigued at the 50% mark, and from there, other than, well, the fact that we don't know what we're doing and we can't actually see the light at the end of the tunnel, we feel that it's probably time just to call it quits and do something else. And that's totally fine. As I said, you don't have to complete this course in one go, although I'd still recommend doing that. It's always a good idea just to take a break and do something else if you feel a little bit burned out from it. Okay? But the fact that you've gotten this far means that you are determined to try and get to the finish line, and the rest of this course is going to be a lot more interesting. Okay? So you've already gotten a very basic taste of that. Now, in this intermission video, I want to share with you guys some resources that I've acquired over the years and just give you some of my viewpoints about some of these websites and resources that you might need. Well, actually, I would say you will actually need these resources later down the track, okay? Because it's no good just watching this particular tutorial course hoping for the best that you will get really good. You can't. It's just not possible. This is a basic course to give you the an idea of how the principles work in tandem with each other. That by itself is not going to be enough, okay? You're going to need additional resources to improve, and that includes our AAA production mentors, for example, which I'll show you in a second. You need training from people who have worked in the industry for many years in different specializations. And obviously, if you want to specialize in one particular area, for example, animation, you're going to need additional resources, okay? So the fastest way to improve your skill is to always find a project that you really want to do, like a passion project, for example, something you can call your own. And from that, okay, from your passion project, learn the tutorials next to each other. Because if you can learn your tutorials while you're doing your passion project, that gives you a lot of motivation to get better and keeps you fresh and keeps this whole process very fun. Because if it's not fun, if it gets boring, you're just going to quit and you're not going to come back. So that's the number one tip, is that you need to stay motivated throughout the entire process. And the more fun the project is for you, personally speaking, the better, okay? So let's just head over to the web browser right now, and I have talesofnullstone.com. Now, this is my personal website. You guys can go ahead and take a look at that in your own time. But in this website, what I've included is an asset library that you can go and download some models for yourself, okay? So you can use these models in your video games or your animation. The asset library is available for everyone, right? And you can purchase anything or any of the assets that I have in there. Now, this is obviously by itself not enough. You're going to have to get some additional resources as well. So I'm going to show you some extra things that you can take a look at. Now, the first place I want to show you is the Gnomon Workshop. If you're the kind of person who wants to work in the industry, okay, maybe the VFX industry or work on big movies, for example, then head over to the gnomonworkshop.com. This is a great place to get AAA training. Now, these people, the lecturers here, the mentors, they're people who have worked in the industry. And we're not talking about just freelance work with a corporate client and such. We're talking about AAA production level, AAA level stuff, okay? These are people who have worked in big movies, big name studios. They know what they're doing. They know exactly how the workflow goes. And if that's what you want to pursue, okay, if that's what you want to do in the long term, then head over to gnomonworkshop.com and get yourself a subscription. Now, in the past, they only had just prices for each course, okay? So maybe it's like a animation course and such, so you'd have to pay maybe $60, $80 for an animation course. Not anymore. You can get yourself a subscription, which is probably better for most people. Get a monthly subscription of about $60, and you have access to the entire library. So go ahead and do that. Check that out whenever you have time. I highly recommend it, and I've personally used some of the Gnomon Workshop tutorial packages myself. I think the training is top-notch, it's very good, and very high level as well, and definitely recommended by me. So I give this a double thumbs up for, if I were to give that a score, that's my score, double thumbs up. So really, really good website. Another website you can also take a look at is digitaltutors.com. Now, this is very similar to the Gnomon Workshop. These guys have been up for a few years. I've been following them ever since they opened up, when I think lay mid-2005, I think, I'm not sure. But these guys are really good because they provide you a wider array of tutorials. And the best part is, If you don't, if you can't find a specific software tutorial from the Gnomon Workshop, chances are very good that Digital Tutors actually has it. Now, the main disadvantage of Digital Tutors, I would say personally, from experience anyway, and by the way, I have used Digital Tutors before, is that their level of training is a little less. It's a little less AAA. It's not exactly at the highest level in terms of, well, high-end productions, but they give you really good training for a wide array of different software packages. So if you want to learn Cinema 4D, this is the place to go. There are plenty of tutorials for that. If you want to learn game engine design or programming, this is also another place to go as well. So web development, it's just everything is pretty much here for you to, well, create your work, all right? So if you can't find any tutorials on the Gnomon Workshop, chances are really good it's down in Digital Tutors. And I personally think this is a really good website for more casual learners. Okay, so if you don't want to get into the AAA production studios, then that's totally fine. And if you just want to work on your own personal business, then head over to digitaltutors.com, get yourself a subscription, and you get access to all the tutorials you need in there. Really, really good website. I highly recommend it. Again, double thumbs up. Really good. Now, for those who want to get into animation specifically, and this is probably more for those who want to work on things like cartoons or, I don't know, 3D animation films, 3D animated films, whatever that may be, then Animation Mentor is a really, really good place to go. The disadvantage, I would say, is probably the price. The pricing is a little bit more expensive than the typical Gnomon Workshop, but what you actually get are mentors who have worked in the industry and interact with you directly, okay? I'm not talking about you just posting stuff on a forum, although you do that as well, but I'm talking about them actually talking to you one-on-one, saying, hey, your animation is not great, you're going to have to change the timing on this because it doesn't feel right, to make it feel a little bit more loose, you've got to do this, this, this. These guys are also really good. Again, I followed them since they started up in, I think, around 2000, maybe a little bit earlier. And I've checked out the work that comes out from the students as well. And as you know, for me, when I judge a college or a tertiary education organization, I always see the results that they bring out, okay? So Animation Mentor is really good. They, like I said, they are a little bit more expensive, so you're going to have to sort out your own financing. I'm not sure if they do that here. But because they have AAA mentors, okay, or mentors who have worked in AAA productions, you're going to get real professional training, okay? So it's not going to be simple, boring, cheap animation you come out after 3 years in college. This is going to be the real deal stuff. If you want to find a job in big studios, go here. They'll teach you and they'll get you up to speed as fast as you can possibly handle it. Okay, so take a look at that, animationmentor.com. Now, if you can't afford that, and that's okay, then you can get what's called Animator's Survival Kit. Now, this is created by Richard Williams. And if you don't know Richard Williams, he's an animator in the industry who's worked in there for many years. A lot of people consider him to be like a grandmaster of animation. And because he's so good at it, because he's done it for so long, he's developed or compiled a bunch of diagrams and principles that you can easily follow. Now, it doesn't even matter if you don't know how to do animation. You just get this and then you're pretty much set, okay? So I personally have purchased this myself. I actually bought the book, so I didn't get the DVD set. The DVD set here is, I think, about $800 or $700. You can go ahead and take a look at that. But I purchased the book, and in the book, it's just one giant cheat sheet, to be honest, because he's drawn up a bunch of diagrams that you simply just copy and follow, and you have really, really good animation already, okay? I got the book for about $50, $60, and if that's something you want to get into, then it's definitely a must-have, okay? So any animators who work in the industry, I would almost say they probably have this in their back pocket, so to speak. There's also an iPhone app or iPad app that you can also get if you don't feel like getting the DVD or the book itself. Either way, lots of really, really good useful principles in there that make animation super easy for you to understand. Okay, so go ahead and take a look at that at theanimatorssurvivalkit.com. Now, throughout the course, I did mention that it's important to get yourself in an art community. And most artists already do this innately, but I thought I'd just remind you anyway, just in case you don't do it. Websites like cgtalk.com, or in this case, it's called cgsociety.org. They have forums in here where you can interact with other artists as well. you know, get some constructive feedback or give feedback for other people about things that you've learned yourself. Everyone's always learning new things, okay? So that's the main idea about these forums. It's just to help you get connected with other people. And I'll explain a little bit about connection later, because it helps you to find people to work with, and that will also increase your chances in getting better. Increase your chances in finding work, especially if they are people who work in the industry already. But forums like this are very useful because you can go and interact with other people. Now, aside from the forums here, CG Society, they also have workshops. Okay, so up here we've got a bunch of workshops that you can go ahead and take a look at. And in these workshops, it's very similar to Animation Mentor. In these workshops, they have a bunch of videos that you just follow over a course of about 8 to 12 weeks, something like that. And what you do is you create your work, post it up on the forums, okay, a private forum in there for you and the mentor and a bunch of the other students as well, and you get feedback directly from the mentor. Now, this is very useful, especially if you're struggling with trying to figure out how to get certain aspects of your art right. All right, and it's really good because these mentors, they interact directly with you. They'll give you feedback and say, hey, you got to fix up this. And as always, learning from a mentor is much quicker than learning by yourself, okay? Unless you're really motivated and you do that every day. That's why I always recommend finding a mentor to help you. The workshops here are really good because I think they're just a fantastic, affordable way for a lot of budding artists to get better at the craft or get up to speed at a professional, to a professional level as quickly as possible. All right, so plenty of little workshops right here from people who also work in the industry, very similar to Animation Mentor and the Gnomon Workshop. All right, so you can go ahead, take a look at some of these things, a few other posts as well, and also it's a good place to get inspired. Okay, when you look at other artists' work, you see how far they've gone and the work they've done, you will automatically get inspired and go, oh man, I'm more motivated to create my own work now, let's just see what I can do. Okay, so go ahead, take a look at that in your own time. I highly recommend it. This is definitely going to get a thumbs up from me. So, and the best part is you can also have your own portfolio. So I've got my own portfolio here, which, by the way, isn't very isn't very prominent, but that's okay. This is just some of the work that I've done over the years. I haven't put up everything I've done. Mainly, the only stuff I've mainly put up is just things related to Tales of Nullstone. All right. So cgsociety.org, really, really good website. Go ahead and take a look at that in your own time. Another website I want to share with you is unrealengine.com. Now, I've done a lot of, a little bit of game development with various game engines like Unity, CryEngine, and I think recently I even tried something, I can't even remember what it's called. I think it was Ogre 3D, something like that. Okay, and game engines, they're simply just, well, it's just an engine. It doesn't really do anything other than grab the models that you've created, put it inside a scene or inside the workflow, and create a game for you. Okay, so you can do a little bit of programming for that. But UnrealEngine.com, they've released recently Unreal Engine 4, which is really good because I actually love Unreal Engine. I've used it since Unreal Engine 3. And I personally think it's a great way to create your game assets or whatever that may be. And the main part that I love about the Unreal Engine is that they have a very indie-friendly licensing. Okay, so you buy the Unreal Engine for $19 a month, which, by the way, you can cancel anytime, and you still keep the current version. Okay, you just don't get any additional updates, so you can still continue working on your projects. But their licensing is really, really friendly. It's just 5% of any royalties that you get. Okay, so maybe from funding or from sales of your video game. So they get 5%. You keep the other 95%, and everybody's happy. And the best part is the community here is really, really friendly. They've got tutorials that you can take a look at. I've done some tutorials myself in my YouTube channel, which you can take a look at that in your own time. They also have like a answer hub, which is really good. You can ask questions in there, and then a bunch of people will answer it for you. It's really, really friendly environment, and I personally think Unreal Engine is one of the best. Now, I've used CryEngine and Unity as well. I think out of the three, between the three, I would still choose Unreal Engine, mainly because the licensing is a lot more friendly, okay? And that, and on top of the fact that the community is really, really helpful. So you can take a look at that. They've also got a marketplace, which, by the way, you can also sell your models here if you have like high quality models that other people can use, and you can also check out some of their examples as well. All right, so really, really good website. I personally give this another double thumbs up for this. Highly recommended if you are interested in getting into game development. Now, cgtextures.com is like a go-to place for a lot of artists. I like this place because not only do they have a lot of different textures here, but the licensing is also indie friendly, so you can take a look at the licensing. You can create a free account, which is about 16 megabytes of download quota per 24 hours. So within the 24 hours, you can download 16 megabytes worth of textures for yourself, use them in your projects, and that's basically it. It's really, really good. And you can also alter your textures and then sell your 3D assets to whatever website you want, if that's what you get into. Really, really helpful. You can also get a membership, which gives you, I think, about 100 megs of download a day. If you're using a lot of textures, then this is probably a really good thing. I love cgtextures.com. It's just a website that I've been using for many years. You should bookmark this if you're interested in getting into the texturing of any 3D models, okay? Now, other websites you can take a look at include conceptart.org. Now, I'm not actually on here, but I have followed their forums. I have taken a look at here, and I have considered actually throwing up jobs for people to apply for. So, aside from the forums, which is the typical community, you can also post up jobs for people out there. So if you need a concept artist for your projects, just go ahead, post up some jobs here and make some connections for yourself. It's a really, really good website. I think it's really good. They've made a few changes recently, so I'm not too sure what has changed aside from, well, I think there's some pricing here. So I believe that's, okay, yep. So you get access to, well, workshops as well. So recently they've included workshops, apparently. This is not something I knew, but you can go ahead and take a look at some of the details here. Now, if you don't like websites like that, you can go to a more casual place, a place like deviantart.com, where you have all kinds of artists just casually throwing stuff up here. And it's a great fun place to put up your work because people interact with you. And yeah, I personally think this is a great place to go for because a lot of people, when you first start up, you don't really have the skills to interact with the high level professionals here, okay? So it's not to say that they're snooty at all, but it does tend to feel that way, I would say. But here's a great place to throw up your work if you're a beginner, because there are so many different artists here that they'll just interact, and it's a great place to make some friends. And speaking of connections and friends, DeviantArt is also a good place to ask for commissions, okay, for cheap commissions if you can't afford a high-level professional. Just look around DeviantArt.com, find a particular art piece that you like, that you feel that sort of matches your style of artwork or whatever it is you want to create, like a character, for example, and just send them a note, ask them, hey, can I commission you for some work? Most artists will say, yeah, I'm happy to do that. They'll draw out a, you know, character sheet for you to use in your own projects. And connections are really important because there's no way you can be a one-man army, okay? And I did say this before, being a generalist means you may know a lot of things, but you're not going to be a high-level professional at any one thing, or it's very difficult to, okay, because it takes a lot of focused effort and time to get good at that specialization. So if you're not good at drawing, go to deviantart.com, interact with the people there, ask around, and find someone who can draw for you, and maybe even teach you some of the ropes as well if you want to get into that, okay? So that's basically it. That's all the resources I just wanted to share with you. That's not everything, of course. There are plenty of resources you can take a look at. You can also take a look at my channel, okay? And in my channel, I do a little bit of live streaming. So if you want to interact with me while I work, I can answer some questions for you and help you out. I also do some live streaming mainly related to Unreal Engine, okay? So anything to do with Unreal Engine, I usually do stuff here. And apparently a lot of people find that very popular and very useful, okay? So you can take a look at that this YouTube channel and subscribe and keep up to date with the posts that I put up here on a regular basis. Okay, so I'll leave that with you guys. I know that's a lot of information, but just remember, not all the resources you see here are going to be useful for you. It's going to depend on your circumstances and your personal goals. But as long as you understand that the resources are there for you, you can, you know, go ahead and take a look at it at your own time if you ever feel the need. And hopefully that will increase your skill set, okay? Because that's the main reason why I want to share with you these resources, because you can't get really good just by one single course, namely mine. Right, so take a look at the resources in your time. I'll see you guys in the next part of this character course.